will come out right in the end.
Oh, my dear, dear Lydia.
She will be married. Oh, my good, kind brother. I knew how it would be. I knew he would manage everything. Oh, but the clothes. And, of course, she must be married from Longbourn. This is all nonsense about her being married from Cheapside. She must be married in Longbourn Church, where all her friends can see her.
No, ma'am, that is not possible. You must see that.
I do not see that. Why should I see that? Why should that be?
Because she has been living with Mr. Wickham in London. And if she were to arrive home unmarried still...
Oh, well, I suppose it must be if you put it like that. But it is all very vexing, and your uncle has been most high-handed. I don't see why he should take so much upon him.
Mama, we are greatly indebted to Mr. Gardiner.
He must have laid out a great deal of money to pay off Mr. Wickham's debts. More than we can ever repay.
And why should he not? Who else should lay out money but our own uncle?
Mother.
Oh, well, I am so happy. A daughter married and only just 16. Mrs. Wickham. Ooh, how well that sounds. Oh, but the wedding clothes. Lizzie, my dear, go down to your father and ask how much he will give her.
Oh, Jane, as soon as I am dressed, I shall go to Meryton and tell my sister Phillips. Oh, ring the bell for Hill. And airing would do me a great deal of good, I'm sure. Oh, and I shall call on Lady Lucas and Mrs. Long. Oh, Jane.
Papa.
Jane, it's such wonderful news. Oh, where is Hill? Oh, Hill, have you heard the good news?
Shut the door, Liz.